Anyway, on Game May, live with us in the studio, man. You got shout-outs out the wazoo. Yeah. Go ahead, man. Kick some of them.
Can I? All right, cool. All right. Here's a shout-out to Justin Kelly, Pip, Kat, Amanda Brooks, Courtney Ferber, Brittany, my little brother Justin, my cousin Janelle, Amber, and Kyle.
Look at that. This man's got more shout-outs than I have friends on MySpace.
I got three shout-outs myself.
Do you? Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
Schleppy Two Boots.
You always give a shout-out to him.
I want to send a shout-out to John's little brother, Justin, and I want to also send a shout-out to Mom. Mom, I love you.
Bob, you can't go within 200 feet of a school or a Chuck E. Cheese, can you?
No.
I didn't think so. Anyway, so Long Came May live in the studio with us. We were talking about is the MySpace the best way to get up with you?
Yeah, to talk to me. I mean, I talk on Facebook too, but I'm more.
Do you
on
have
MySpace,
a fan page,
you know,
set up on Facebook too?
On Facebook or MySpace? Yeah.
On Facebook.
Oh, I don't even.
You don't know how yet.
Do that stuff on Facebook.
We'll have to show you how to
do
that. Yeah, MySpace is it's always a good way to interact with people. And again, MySpace.com/AlongCameMay. And like we were talking about earlier, I'm still intrigued by the fan sign idea.
Yeah, that's incredible.
That's not only interesting to me, but it's incredible, like, the response you've got. Do you put out, like, do you say, hey, send in your fan signs? Or...
Well, I do now. Like, I do some of them.
Yeah.
Like, I've read on my page for a while, like maybe the past 2 weeks or something. It was like, make me a sign that's featured on a vid. Because I wanted to do a vid. I mean, I had a lot of signs, but, if I get more of
the more you do, the longer the video can be.
Some of those people get pretty creative with their pictures,
yes,
too.
Yes,
they do.
It's fun looking at them.
And, I know where this whole thing started. It was a music video, and it wasn't pictures. It was actually people, like, holding up words on their hands and stuff like that. But I can't remember what it was. It was like
you're not thinking of, like,
it was based off
TV. NXS.
No. It was based off a TV thing, and it was just like a hope for. It was almost like a Hope for Haiti type deal. But it wasn't.
Really?
It was way longer back than that. It was something else that it. I think it was Tsunami Relief, to be honest, or something like that. You remember the Tsunami?
Oh yeah.
That's when Alice in Chains got back together. Man, I've seen them. It was a good show. Speaking of which, make sure you keep it locked right here for your Alice in Chains tickets. Anyway,
I already got those. I saw them and I grabbed them.
Did you?
Yeah, no.
I'm going with you.
They're mine. I got it.
Anyway, make sure you check us out online, WZBHrocks.com. We got enough time for a couple more songs. You were saying you wanted to play one off the CD?
Yeah, I want to play Tangled.
Okay. Tell us about it a little bit. Tell me about the song.
Once again, you know.
Same deal, different boat.
Kind of, but it's more like, I guess it's kind of like looking back at stuff, you know.
I can dig.
I mean,
so,
if you listen to the lyrics, you'd understand, I guess.
Just to ask a question.
He's a man after my own heart. He's a very sentimental gentleman.
Yeah. You gotta be. Music, man.
Yeah, I don't know.
Just to ask the question and kind of put it out there, and you know, you could slap me down at anything. Is it kind of a concept album?
What does that mean?
Like, do you have kind of a common theme throughout the album?
I don't think so.
No, you just kind of, you know.
Did the songs, and I mean, we put it together.
That's cool. Yeah, the songs, like we said, they sound great. And
I like them all.
When we come back, I'm going to tell you.
I love acoustic music.
Me too.
So, you know, you can't go wrong with a long.
And do you do everything acoustic?
What do you mean?
Like, do you specifically play
everything?
Not really but when you record, do you record everything with an acoustic guitar? Or?
Well, at first, I mean, I record everything because that's where I write everything, you know, in my bedroom usually, you know.
Cool.
With all my stacks of notebooks, I find a page, you know.
You gotta start somewhere, man.
You know, and I write it with my guitar, we get on the bass, and me and my dad record it, you know.
Cool.
And the video I recorded of you that's gonna be on the Local Produce MySpace later on this evening, look for it tomorrow, you actually played a mandolin.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's on Nana. I play the mandolin
on
it.
The Nana song.
Multi-talented, man.
Song.
Do you tend to stick to the mandolin and guitar? Or do you sometimes
Out of there? I can't say I really stick to the mandolin.
Yeah.
I mean, I picked it up and I kind of like made something
just
up
been playing
and I
with
just
it ever since.
Went with it, you know?
Cool.
But I have different instruments and different songs.
Now, do you take, you were talking about school earlier, do you take any kind of lessons at school? Have you taken lessons or do anything like that? Or is it all just
self-taught?
A long time ago, I take guitar lessons, but I mean, I really taught myself. Basically, my dad taught me, you know.
Yeah, just
really
picked up what you can, where you can, and keep moving on.
Kind of,
I noticed. Correct me if I'm wrong, but you don't play in a standard tuning, do you?
I play in different tunings. Honestly,
yeah.
Like some songs I'll play in normal tuning, like, but a lot of them I play drop. I can't say drop. It's like minor or flat.
Drop D.
Not drop D. I don't play drop D, really.
Just drop a couple strings here and there, like an open.
I know, like, the Goo Goo Dolls, he has, like, a different tuning for almost every song.
Yeah,
you know? I mean, it's
a
good
cool.
way to, like,
it's
make
cool.
yourself
up. To be honest, that's a hard way to go about doing things, mm-hmm. because a lot of people, you know, it's a good way to do it, yeah. but a lot of people will get stuck in this box when they're writing, you know, they'll yeah. have, like, they'll have, they always play in standard tuning, or a lot of bands, they always play in standard or drop D, or they go mm-hmm. back and forth, or even with flat tunings and open tunings, a lot of bands, they tend to learn that tuning, mm-hmm. you know, from the top to bottom, every scale there is, mm-hmm. and they're a whiz, but the problem is change a string, no. yeah, you change yeah. a string, and it's over.
Yeah.
You're
yeah.
You're sitting there playing live, your guitar goes out of tune, what do you do then? You know?
I just can't wait to hear you at 20.
Yeah, right.
Oh, I mean, I'm hoping I'll be somewhere by then, man.
You're going to be on the road. We'll be calling you. Hey, remember us? John, come back, man. Remember us little people?
Well, let's kick it, man. Along Came May is the name of the group. This song is called Tangled, right here on Delmarva's Rock Radio 93.5 The Beach.
Local produce.
Thank you, Bob.
Go ahead.
She clings to my fingertips, her head laid across my chest, my heart beating ever so fast, and her hair tangled in a knot. Come on, baby, give me what you got. We both lie staring quite still.
Yeah, look at that, Bob. We're running over a little bit. Still Marvin's Rock Radio 93.5 The Beach, of course.